नमस्कार, हेलो एंड वेलकम टू एनसीईआरटी स्पेशल लाइव फोन इन प्रोग्राम वेबिनार। माय नेम इज तन्वी खुराना एंड इन दिस वेबिनार वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द जर्नी ऑफ अ नेशनल आईसीटी अवॉर्डी। वेल, जर्नीज आर फुल ऑफ चैलेंजेस, अप्स एंड डाउन, दे आर ऑफ एक्सपीरियंसेस। And what is so special about this ICT journey, this National ICT Awards journey? So let's talk to our expert for today. She is Ms. Kavita Kar. Welcome, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you, Tanvi. And thank you, all my viewers. Namaste.
Thank you and welcome to our program once again, ma'am. I'll introduce you to our viewers. Ma'am is a National ICT awardee and she got the award in 2014. She is from Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalay, Ganjam, Odisha. And she's going to talk about her journey. If you have any interest in her journey and you want to know what were the challenges, how did she manage, how did she handle all those challenges, and how did she begin? So what was so interesting about that? A lot of questions are there in her journey. If you want to raise those questions, please feel free to send in your questions through our YouTube channel, which is NCERT Official. In the live chat box, write down your queries and share them with us. We are here till 5 o'clock and she'll be more than happy to take all your queries. If you want to give us a call, the number is on your screens at the moment, 8800 440 559. And if you want to give us an email ID, that is training@ciet.nic.in. So let's begin this discussion and I would ask ma'am, how was this journey? What was your experience? What are you going to share with our viewers in this program? Please tell us all about it. Ma'am, can you hear me?
Yes, yes. Good afternoon, everybody. Myself, Kavita Kar, working as vice principal in Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalaya, Ganjam. And before that, I was having experience of teaching physics and science in different classes. But the help of ICT tools is really implemented during this pandemic, and I am thankful to CIT, NCERT, Anjali Madam, Vera Sir, and all their team who has given us the scope to come forward and implement it during this pandemic time when it was very much necessary. And we implement, share, collaborate, and do it in a better way, in a qualitative way, for all the times to come. So before starting this discussion on my journey, how I approach and how I achieve and what are the pros and cons I have in my life, I want to share my total from beginning of my student career as well as professional career. So I want to screen share.
We have your screen, ma'am. Yes.
Okay, madam. Okay, but my face was not visible, that's why I thought. Okay. Okay. So myself, I have completed my degree in different institutions. I am a National ICT awardee the year 2013, given in the year 2014, and also I got this NBS incentive award meant for Navodaya teachers, and have a certified key resource person educated from on behalf of CIT and NCERT. So this is my educational career, and as a student I have come across with different institutions. These are the some of the glimpses of my me as a child. It is my first school, Jagaman High School, Bardang, in the district of Kendrapada in Odisha. It was the real school where I know what science is, how we can implement in our life. Though it was very, very rural school, there is no scope. but the type of teaching I got from my teachers, it implant me how to advance in life. Then I was a student in Revansha College, and it is one of the oldest college in our country, and I have completed my intermediate graduation, post graduation in that college. I am proud to be Revanshavian. Particularly all my friends who helped me in this field, whether it is ICT or any kind of activities, I got their help, and I am proud to be a student of that college. Then I am having B.Ed and M.Phil degree in those reputed institutions. Then my professional career starts from this Atomic Energy Center School, Kota, Rajasthan, where I work as PGT. Because of some family constraint, I have to leave that job, and again I enter into Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalaya, Mayurbhanj, in the year 1996. From 96 to till 2020, I was working as a postgraduate teacher in physics, and completed 24 years of teaching in physics subject as well as science subject. And after that, I got promoted to this administrative job, and now I am working here in JNV Ganjam as vice principal. But still, I am continuing my teaching learning activity through ICT. I inspire my teachers, my students, to have more and more use of ICT in their every, whether it is a lesson in science or art or any kind of subject. Nowadays it becomes a common, but the time when we are the teachers, at that time it was a daydream of thinking of ICT. So these are the glimpse of my school where I teach in the first time in the year 1995. Then JNV Mayurbhanj, where I shifted to after living at Atomic School. Then I work in JNV Dhenkanal, then JNV Chhattisgarh in Sarguja district, then JNV Khurda. After that, this is the school where I am working now as vice principal, and Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalaya Ganjam, it is in the state of Odisha. Then because of my academic proficiency, I produce good result, both quality as well as quantity. Percentage wise, I got this Guru Shrestha, Guru Sri award from different years, and this shield is there for our combined effort of all the science teachers, where our school stood second in CBC result of that particular year 2018 in the whole country. And those are the some of the certificates. Then as a teacher in Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalaya, where the school is mainly placed in remote areas and children are from rural background, there are many constraints are there. Still I enjoy the job, because we got it is a residential setup. With the initial days, there were no such a computer facility. Schools are in remote areas, and because of its geographic location also, networking is a daydream initially. And nowadays also we are struggling to get a better networking facility for our students. And here we are having computer science lab with outdated system, though we are trying every time. But this networking is a great issue for the Navodaya schools. So there is a limited access of technology to the students, because they are from very poor background also. And many of the students, even they don't have the device. And that was that we come to know during these days, how it is difficult to teach the children in online mode. So there are many demerits are there, but still children are of that age group who have the access. They are very much interested to learn. They are in the learning group of they say 11 to 18 years, and it is full because of fully residential setup. We got sufficient time for the students to be utilized for different purposes, for whether it is co-curricular activities or academic activity or any kind of activity. We can take the children to practice them. They can be useful for any kind of work. They can get trained, and we can have practice them for learning of suppose it is a CCA activity or any kind of activity they can be used for. So we are having well equipped smart lab nowadays with this learning age group students, and we are also getting the facility from CIT and NCERT, where there is a Diksha training and it is imparted to all the teachers, and nowadays all the teachers are taking the help of that training and implementing there in every sphere, whether it is academic or suppose like a cyber security or RTI, any kind of thing they can also learn and implement it in their life, as well as they can teach the students in NCERT book almost all the subjects, all the chapters. It has been taught by different experts, and they can help the take the help of that Diksha portal for improving their teaching learning process, as well as imparting the same to the students. Then previously the time when there is no scope here, I used to take the help of the students, try to improve their learning horizon by exposing them to different kind of competitions, whether it is the regional science congress program or it is a national children science congress program or any kind of activity in the form of competitions. Always I expose my children and act as a guide and facilitator, so that they excel in that field. And here are some of the pictures that my children excel in different level, whether it is national one or regional or inter-school competition. Always there is a scope for learning and improving. So every time I encourage my children to participate in different kind of competition, and they also excel. And taking their interest, I think that it should be more and more, it can be highlighted if we take the help of ICT. In those days when the year very back previously, we used to take the children and impact them different like here DLC PC district level competition, then state level competition, then national level competition, all kind of competition they reach. But how to highlight and how to share it, collaborate it with others, we have to take the help of ICT tools, as well as different media like social media or the help of website, where the child can share what he want to know. And I involve my children in different ways, like to know the taking the help of different activities, different projects, different art integrated approach of teaching, as well as field tour, and inter-school competitions in different sphere. I used to expose them, and I hope that the children should get the effective learning in different sphere. So what they get is that is I feel that is the success for me, if it is the success for my children. Then here are some of the pages where we use the concepts of for learning science in different way, and I exposed my children here in this national level competitions. Here are the some of the competitions that my children has reached because of their effort, interest, and my effort. And this is one of the child who achieved the target. Me as the guide, as well as some of my friends, some of the fellow science teachers, we help the children to reach that level. Then we used to have science day program in different way, whether it is a playway method or art integrated method, or by making models and projects. So these are the ways that children should learn. Not only it is only the limited to ICT. How ICT can be implemented to those projects and models, and how it can be modified. That is our motto. Our motto is to have better teaching learning by use of different methods. And nowadays it is in NEP 2020 that we should adopt all those methods, so that the child can be imparted to the actual learning what it is to be. So I act as a facilitator, and here we have a video conferencing with NASA astronaut in the year 2017, where I used to take the children to that sphere where they can know and they can interact with those dignitaries, and they can learn something and implement in their life. So as a science teacher, I used to act as a guide, and here are the some of the certificates that continuously my children reach to that level, and always in a national level sphere, they have their own identity. So here I want to tell you, because those are the things when we have not used ICT to that level, but we want that there should be enhance of a teaching learning process in different ways. So here I want to make it very clear that what should be our aim by using ICT. So here I usually during this pandemic situation, as we are very much acquainted with ICT. Previously, when we don't have this skill, we have the what are the skills we want to show, what are the skills which can be implemented and which can be adopted for better use of learner community itself, students as well as teachers. So my aim is to use ICT tools related to the topic and to clarify the concepts, to construct models and projects, and the devices which are related to clarify the concept. Suppose I want to show a particular concept, which device I should use, that I was thinking previously. But nowadays, when it is online class, which particular tool I should use so that the child will get a clear idea on that particular concept. So my aim is to clear up the concept, whether it is using models, projects, devices, or ICT tools. And also art integrated approach with gamification by use of simulation or animation. That is one way by which your children can learn and have better concept clarification. Then to participate in online quizzes like Kahoot, Google Form, Mentimeter, as well as other online quiz which are available in the our networking form, we can have use that so that children can be exposed to different forms of quizzes. Then converting static picture to video form, because suppose a particular picture is there, suppose it is solar system, and we don't have in the class, we want to show it by different ways. We can take the help of different ways. Physically we can take, if the students are physically with us. If they are not there, we can make it in a visual form where the static picture can be converted to video or moving form. Similarly, preparation of mind map or concept map, where which lesson is taught and learnt by the children, the whole map of the particular class will be in one page, so that in the child can have a concrete idea on the particular subject. Looking at that particular mind map, it can be taken as a mind tree, where we can use different tools to bring the idea in a compact form. Then bringing quality improvement in teaching as per NEP 2020, use of QR code or barcode as ICT tools to learn through Diksha portal. It is a Diksha portal. Nowadays we are having different trainings, and for children we can show it by using this Diksha portal, which is provided as a free resource, open source for all the teachers. Similarly, use of open sources like NROER, OLabs, ePatsala, etc. Open sources where for all the subjects, all the standards, the videos from eminent personalities are available. Use of OLabs, where it is online lab, where the during this pandemic, when this physical presence of students are not possible, this OLab plays a great role, particularly those children who have passed last year and previous to that last year. They used to be adapted with this OLab for practicing all the experiments, and they also sit for the exam when they have been called, because previously they have been practiced through this online lab method, and it is a great tool for students during this pandemic time. Then ePatsala, where all the different books are available, so that children can use it for their future, as well as teachers can use. If a particular book is not available, it can be downloaded and be used. Then why I think that linking of ICT should be there in teaching learning process, because it is a great skill to not to limit the teaching in a classroom. It should be imparted to those who are needy, who cannot get the scope. They can be get the benefit of it. And this one I have used during the days when it is around 2002. During that time, we don't have this facility of a computer lab, everything, very less number of computers are there. But we thought that use of this ICT and use of computer facilities can be imparted to our children as well as the neighboring students who are not having this computer in their school, particularly to the state government students who are there staying nearer to Jawahar Navodaya. We used to call those children to get this computer literacy program, and that is one of the fact we have started in Navodaya Vidyalayas to impart this literacy program to the students of neighboring schools. Then I have added multimedia to improve the quality of our teaching by taking the children, those children what concept we have asked to clarify, then we give that you yourself explain, that child, he take the interest, and we take the videograph of the particular concept what is discussed by the child, then we showcase it to other students, so that there is, during that time, the speaking capability, listening capability, as well as clarifying a concept by the children itself is improved. So that one is taken and uploaded in our YouTube channel or website, so that other students get the benefit of that particular activity or project, and children, they themselves come up, they show the interest that we want to show this concept through this small hands-on experiment or through this small activity where it is not given in the book. That is a great thing what I found. Many of the students, they come forward from their own to showcase their skills in different fields. So this multimedia also help in improving the quality of teaching, which is there in my website, as well as it is there in the YouTube channel. So here, the ICT tools help in widening the horizon of learning in this way, that the children get more and more interest, that their work has been showcased by the people like teacher or principal, so they are very much interested to show it. As well as the use of social media for spreading the idea, what they have shown, if we take the help of our different social media, Twitter or our this website or YouTube channel, then that idea will be spread, the comments from other can be taken into account to modify or improve it. So that is another great thing. Similarly, participation with collaborative teams. This one I start doing when I come to know one of the educational website like ThinkQuest, where the 3C method are followed. That is communication, collaboration, and creativity, where this wonderful tool or wonderful website, I was the administrator of that site, what I come to know from different seminars, workshops, trainings which was conducted by NVS. From there I come to know regarding this wonderful site, that is ThinkQuest, who is work under Oracle Foundation, and I as an administrator took some of the teachers and students under me, and we started collaborating with different schools and share the ideas and improve our improve our way of presenting ourselves in different sphere. So that I come to know from this Oracle Education Foundation, that this is the website where it is providing free platform for collaborative projects, with this motto of our competition, creativity, collaboration and communication. And first time I was invited to JNV Vilaspur, where the experts who have come, from them I got inspiration, and I work in that website with the help of some of my teachers and students on, who work under me, I being the administrator. So that Oracle Education Foundation, who gives the platform for me how to share and collaborate, there I learned a lot. And that website, nowadays it is not there, but there I learn the different basics, what way, in which way we can use it for teaching learning process and improving the teaching learning by collaborating, sharing and communicating in the global sphere. So this is the institute where I have been imparted the training with some of the great resource persons, where we start taking the help of the resource persons for 3-4 days. They have taught us how to use the concepts and implement it and collaborate with other people. So from there we learnt the use of multimedia and take the children into account that they also do research in different field. Suppose it is PPT or it is your Google Form work or any kind of work. Particularly in that website, when we want to do some work, we collaborate with other schools and share our ideas, so that it is a great learning platform. So here are different approach of teaching, where I learn from that website. I used to have a number of projects, and those projects got recognition. Here are some of the ways of teaching, and while teaching also I kept it in mind that those projects should be showcased to others. So those are the some of the important methods of teaching through models and project making. Children should learn through activity method also, children can learn. Then through role play method of teaching also, we have performed different kinds of approach that children should learn from them. Then here are the some of the animated storytelling methods. Children themselves, they have the innovative idea to write on global warming or water crisis or some of the common problems what we face. They approach it in such a nice way that it was the right thing to be showcased to others. So it is the animated storytelling method, as well as different models and projects, all are done by children, and they take the help of different sites, different tools, and showcase it in different methods. Then those are the some of the activities what they have been inspired, they do, they try to get it from the idea from different ways, from browsing as well as from library, from other sources, and they make the 3D model of that one and explain it, and all those things are stored as a storehouse in my website, as well as in the school website it is stored. So these are the ways to inspire the children to learn, so that it will be a great inspiration for others. Because of my work in those fields, as well as use of different tools and showcasing the things to the children, and my use of different ICT tools to bring the change in the teaching learning process, I received this award in the year 2014 for the year 2013, and this is a wonderful achievement. Really, I was very much grateful to my Navodaya Vidyalaya Samiti, who has given me this opportunity to participate. My presentation has been taken into account in the national level sphere. Then there it has been sent to NCERT, and finally, out of whole country, out of 596 schools, how many teachers have been applied? Only two teachers have been selected to get this award, and I am really grateful to my samiti, my principal, my institution, as well as the NCERT as a whole, who has given me this wonderful chance to receive this award. And there is a galaxy of teachers who got from different institutions, not only Navodaya, from KB, Chinese school, and other colleges are also there, who are there among us in that year, in the year 2013. For the year 2013, we received in the year 2014. Then we got the chance as National ICT Awardee. We got this chance of participating in National ICT Conference. And because of this our inclination towards ICT, I have been given the chance of formulating roadmap on digital learning for JNVT schools. And I, along with some of the teachers, are the members for that committee. How to implement ICT and how to improve the roadmap for digital learning for the students, school students. Then, because of that, in the JNVST application form, my name has been highlighted, which is a great inspiration for me, as well as to other teachers. If they work and get the scope, they work outside this boundary, then they must be recognized, what I feel. So it is an inspiration not to me, for other teachers who are working outside the limit from the classroom teaching, outside if they work, then they must get appreciation. And afterwards, I thought to have increased my sphere of learning to my students. I took the help of some of the children to know which is not there in our school periphery, which is there is no scope of learning of robotics, or there is no scope of learning of which thing I want to make my children to learn. That's why I communicate with people from other places, other countries, and by the help of Skype, I took my interest to teach my children, and robotic training was given by the students from Boston to my children in Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalaya, and they took the help of Skype every week on Saturday and Sunday. They take their help, those high school children of Houston, they give the training to our children, and the children are quite expert, which site is to be included, how to go for a particular project, and how to implement it in the greater sphere. All those things has been taught by those children of Houston High School, Synchronous High School of Houston, and it has been taught to the children of Jawahar Navodaya Khurda. So I request them, if it is, there is a chance that we can have a workshop in JNV. So in my request, they have come, and in the year 2015, we have a workshop in our school periphery, where we have this workshop, and after that workshop, again we want to showcase it in the next year, where the children has been allowed by our principal to showcase their activities and projects in the Rahagiri program at Bhubaneswar. It is a program where children can show their talents in various ways, whether it is scientific model or yoga program or dance program. Any kind of a program can be showcased in a road of Bhubaneswar on Sundays, and it was conducted in the 25th December of 2016, where this particular program has been showcased. We call those teams. Along with those team, our school students, our JNV students are also there. So in a collaborative way, the children showcase their program in the Rahagiri program, or it is Patha Utsav program, which was conducted there. So this was the newspaper cutting of that particular program, and children has done the workshop here. And after workshop, this program was conducted in the road show of Bhubaneswar. And this thing also be learnt by the next generation, what how to use this. The children, they have done the workshop in our school, and those are the students from Cinco Ranch High School of Texas.
Okay, so this is the robot that we built together, and there are several different parts to it. So the robot has two motors in the back, or in the bottom of the robot, which moves the wheels, these treads, which allows the robot to move.
Okay. Next, as a mentor, I have been involved in different activities, whether it is a science training program on PISA, or as a judge in district level science drama competition, or it is the Children's Science Congress program. I have my role. So those are the training and conference what I participated in different years.
And ma'am, we've got last 5 minutes left.
Okay. And those are the recognition what I got from my samiti. And these are the different ways nowadays we are taking classes. Previously, though it was physical class, but I used to take the classes taking OLAPs. And those are the different trainings I have been imparted. Then training imparted to the teachers of JNV to on use of ICT tools, and my MOOC contribution in various forms. Then the different webinars, trainings which has been attended by me, because of the call from CIT from time to time during the pandemic, particularly what steps we have to take as ICT awardee. Then these are the labs, and we used to expose the children. Then awareness program on cyber security. Particularly during this pandemic situation, it was a threat for all devices, So we aware the children. Then it is the CHT training I got, and there I got a lot of ideas from my group of friends, as well as till now also we are learning from each other. And these are the ICT courses I have completed. Then I got the chance to work as a national level speaker on this particular concept of FET, and it has been showcased. Then certificate I got as a resource person in this national level webinar. Then I got the jury member ship in panel inspection. Particularly, I am grateful to my assistant commissioner madam, who gave me the chance to particularly give the concept of ICT tools to my teachers. I expose them during this inspection. I give the tips, what are the tools to be used by the teachers, so that it will be helpful for the our students, and clarify the concepts. So I got the chance to inspect 5-6 schools and the panel inspection team. Then teaching of NROER, OLABS, Diksha portal, all those things I use to tell my teachers, as well as I use it in my class. And this is the use of FET simulation, one kind of tool. Then e-lessons contributed by my students and me in my website, as well as during the classroom teaching. And use of Google Classroom during pandemic. During the time of pandemic, we used to use this mode so that it will be easy to store the homework copies and other evaluations. All those things can be done easily. Then use of different tools. It is whether it is stop motion or Kahoot or mind map, all are used by my children. Then my role as teacher and educator. Then this is the way nowadays we are teaching the students. When it is the case of pandemic, we expose them to for virtual visit. And previously we used to go to the site. Now then different ways we expose them so that they can get the concrete idea. Then my participation in different sphere. Then Diksha portal, which is used by not only principals, teachers, nowadays for students also, it is used for interactive learning. Then as an administrator, I expose my children as well as teachers to have virtual mode of teaching, skill-based learning, and those are the outputs of my children after learning the concept. Teachers used to go to the experts. From there, they give the visual view to the children in a group using Google Meet or any kind of tool where the children can view it, like Zoom or Google Meet, then it can be showcased.
All right. So, ma'am, we can see that you have done great efforts. Your journey is actually very inspiring. All the portals you have used, and you have informed to our viewers that if they'll be using these online methods, it'll be very beneficial and very helpful to all of them. Thank you so much, ma'am, for being with us, for giving us your time, and for sharing your very important and inspiring journey with us. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you to all the viewers for watching this session, and it was a great session. Please stay with us. Don't go anywhere. We are coming back with another special program of ours, which is Sahyog, and the title will be Mental Health and Well-being, the First Aid Kit. So what is this First Aid Kit? We'll let you know in a few minutes, but before leaving, we have a very important announcement for all of you. On your screens, you can see Rashtriya Kala Utsav. स्कूल शिक्षा और साक्षरता विभाग द्वारा शिक्षा मंत्रालय भारत सरकार की पहल पर एनसीईआरटी के सौजन्य से 1 से 12 जनवरी 2022 तक कला उत्सव आयोजित किया जा रहा है। आपको जो लिंक दिख रहा है स्क्रीन पर वो हमारे YouTube चैनल के डिस्क्रिप्शन पर भी दिया गया है, उसके माध्यम से आप इस कार्यक्रम में जुड़ सकते हैं और इसका आनंद ले सकते हैं। तो जुड़ना बिल्कुल मत भूलिएगा, हम उम्मीद करते हैं आप इसका पूरा आनंद लेंगे। तो हमारे साथ जुड़े रहिए, देखते रहिए PM E Vidya चैनल। बहुत बहुत ध्यान रखिएगा। नमस्कार।